After describing how eggs mature in the female ovary, we'll now describe how sperm is produced in male testicles. Sperm cells develop from diploid stem cells that are labeled here by 2N. These stem cells undergo mitosis. Half of the daughter cells will remain diploid stem cells, while the other half undergoes meiosis and differentiation to sperm cells. This mechanism ensures the conservation and renewal of the stem cell pool that permits the production of 100 million sperm cells per day. Sperm cells are produced in the testicles from puberty on for the entire life of the male. Sperm is a highly specialized cell that is well adapted to transferring the genome fast and efficiently to and into the egg, while overcoming huge obstacles on its way. Everything that does not serve this mission is eliminated from the sperm cell. The nucleus takes up the entire volume of the sperm head. The DNA in the nucleus is uniquely packaged like in no other cell. The head is covered with the acrosome, an organelle filled with enzymes that enable penetration into the egg. The basis of the flagellum is rich in mitochondria that provide the energy required for its fast movement. These mitochondria do not normally enter the egg and are not passed on to the next generation that contains only maternal mitochondria from the egg. Spermatogenesis comprises many phases that mostly take place in the seminiferous tubules of the testicles and take about 3 months in men. Testicles are kept outside of the body to maintain the slightly lower temperature required by spermatogenesis. Here we can see sections of mouse testes I prepared for research many years ago. The blue arrows point to cells in different phases of spermatogenesis. The red arrows indicate sperm cells with flagella. We are happy to host Dr. Carmelit Richler that will prepare for us meiotic cells. Dr. Richler worked for many years at the Department of Genetics of the Hebrew University as the right hand of the late Professor Jacob Warman, one of the pioneers of chromosome studies in Israel. The locust grasshopper Dr. Richler is using is a useful model, as we can dissect grasshoppers of known age to obtain specific stages of spermatogenesis. Moreover, grasshoppers have a small number of chromosomes, thus facilitating analysis. Dr. Richler is removing the yellow, fat-covered testicles from the backside of the grasshopper. She is now transferring the testicles into acetoursein, a dye that fixes the cells, dissolves the cytoplasm, and stains the nuclei red. She carefully moves them to a microscope slide. Now she squashes the tissues that contain the sperm cells with a cover slip. Into this apparently simple procedure, Dr. Richler puts decades of experience to obtain optimal results. Next, the mount has to be sealed with wax to prevent it from drying out. Let us now proceed to the microscope to examine the slides. Not only preparation, but also analyzing and interpreting these slides requires a lot of skill. Here, Dr. Richler has spotted several cells at the stage of homologue pairing and crossover in meiosis 1. Here are cells in which the paired homologues already aligned in the middle of the cell. And here is a cell caught in the process of separating its homologues just before completing the first meiotic division. At a different part of the slide, we can see already mature sperm cell heads.